Students, now in today's class module 3, that is about a neural network. So in the previous videos we have studied regarding a neural network, how the neural network is going to be constructed using a single neuron, that is the perceptron, which we have studied in the previous session. So now continuing this neural network, the neural network where it is operations are mainly depends on the weight, which is being keep on updating during the back propagation operation. So if the results are not obtained properly, if the output results which we have obtained is going to get errors, so to overcome that error we try to solve that problem by updating the weights. In a previous class, we have visualized the hypothesis space. So, in the hypothesis space, where we are going to have a, in a three-dimensional space, where we are obtaining a weights, let us consider the weight W1 and weight W2, where is being present in a space. In a hypothesis space, and we try to keep on update the weights and try to minimize the error. So E is a error, that is the surface error, or the output which you have obtained has got an error. That error is going to be minimized. The error is going to be minimized by choosing a global minimum point in this hypothesis space. So here what happened, the gradient descent search determines a weight vector that minimizes the error by starting with its initial point and tries to iterate the process of finding the global minimum and find out the minimum global point. So we can say that at each step the weight vector is going to be altered in a direction where it tries to find out the steepest position and the steepest descent along with the error surface. And this process is going to keep on iteratively continues until it finds the global minimum. So this is what the global minimum error which we are going to find out in a hypothesis space. Now let us continue this class with a derivation of a gradient descent rule. So the gradient descent rule is going to provide you a formula. By using that particular formula, we tries to update the weight and try to minimize the error. Now let us look at the derivation of gradient descent rule. Let us start the derivation of the gradient descent rule. Now, to derive the gradient descent rule, we need to consider the vector of W, that is vector of weight we need to consider, and next the vector derivative must be performed, that is the gradient of E, that is what we call it as the vector derivative. Vector derivative is called gradient of E. So we have to find out the partial derivative of the vector W, that is weight vector. To find out the partial derivative, let us have written this value, that is the summation of all the partial derivatives of weight can be considered in the formula, that is delta E of W, that is vector, weight vector, is equal to partial derivative, that is del of E by del of W0, comma del of E1 divided by del of W1, so on, that is del of E divided by del of E n. It's E E W n. This is what the partial derivative. So in this partial derivative, where we can say that is the direction of the steepest can be found by computing the derivative of E. So by computing the derivative of E, we tries to find out the partial a steepest point in the in a global minimum. Direction of the steepest can be found out by computing the E with respect to the vector of W. So thus we can write the derivative, that is the vector derivative, which we can write is called it as a gradient of E. The gradient of E can be written as delta E with respect to the vector W vector, can be written as del of E by del of W0, del of E by del of W1, and del of E by del of Wn. Now let us consider the gradient specifies. What the gradient specifies? Gradient specifies the direction in which the steepest increase of E, and by using a training rule, that is the gradient descent training rule, which can be written as, that is gradient descent rule, W bar tends to W vector plus delta of W vector, where delta of W vector can also be written as minus eta of delta E of W vector, where eta is a positive constant. Eta is a positive constant called learning rate. It's called a positive constant. So when you look at here in this formula, we can say here is eta is a one, is a positive constant and is also called as a learning rate, which determines the steps size in a gradient descent search. So determines the step in gradient descent search here is what happens in a hypothesis space. When you consider this hypothesis space, where you are going to have a parabolic shape of weights error, which we have got formed out. So here what happens, this learning rate tries to find out the iterative steps of decreasing this error and find out the global minima. So that is what here, why we require this learning rate eta is a positive constant value. Next, why we are going to have a negative value? Why minus here is mentioned over here? Why the minus here is, the negative sign is present because we want to move the weight vector in the direction. See, now the what happens here is, for example, if you consider this is the error, now we have got weight W1, W2 is the weight. We try to minimize the error which is present in the hypothesis space and try to find out the global minimum point. So because of that reason, the weight vector must be move in a decreasing direction. That is, this is what the error which you have got, W1 and W2. Actually, previous class itself I explained this particular diagram. So W1, W2 are the vector. This is what the hypothesis space where we are going to plot, and we have got a weights are being chosen for different iterations, and weights are keep on updating, and then we are going to get a error. We try to minimize the error and get the output in a proper manner with a minimum error. So we need to choose the weight. The weights are going to be chosen in a direction of decreasing the error. We should find the weights with the direction of decreasing the error. So we try to find out the global minimum point. So because of that reason, here the minus is being chosen. Now let us move on to the next step. In rule here is, training rule, we can write it as Wi tends to Wi plus delta Wi. Let us find this equation, number this equation. Now it's a number one, equation number one, and the next one is, this is the equation number two. Okay, the next one here is, now Wi plus delta Wi leads to a Wi, means we need to update the weight so that we are going to obtain the new weight. The new weight is going to address the minimum error. So in place of delta Wi, we can mention this delta Wi vector, that is minus, we can mention delta Wi is equal to, delta Wi is equal to minus eta, that is the learning rate. See, in this place we can mention the partial derivative of the partial derivative. See, in this place we can mention the partial derivative of a W vector, that is we can write del e divided by del of wi. We can say this is the equation number 3. So here what happens, to calculate, now the next step is we need to calculate the value of del E by del W, that's the partial derivatives from the gradient that can be obtaining the training rule. The next step is to calculate the gradient at each step. So for that purpose, the vector of del E by del Wi is a derivatives that forms the gradient and can be obtained by differentiating the E value, by obtained by differentiating E from the equation, this particular equation. This equation must be substituted in the place of E, that is a E is a vector. E corresponds to the gradient where we are going to differentiate E with respect to the W vector, that is a weight vector. Substitute this particular A, equation number A, this A must be substituted in equation number 3, and performing the partial derivative, we are going to obtain the gradient. That gradient is going to calculate a minimum weight value where we are going to obtain the minimum error. So that is the next step. Now let us look at the next step. Have the differentiation of a E, that is the partial differentiating the E, we are going to obtain the delta Wi. Let us look at here differentiation. So del E by del W I is equal to del by del W I, where in place of E we can write the half summation of D belongs to the capital D TD minus OD the whole square. So here small d is refers to the training example, a single instance or a single training example that belongs to the data set D, whereas the TD is a target value. The target value is, you are going to have a target value, so that particular representation can be done by TD. And next OD is the output unit, the output which you have been obtained. So that is what, it's a predicted, you are going to have the target out unit, but this one is the output which you have been obtained. Now by differentiating this, we try to obtain the delta W I. Now this is equal to, so differentiation, you can take the half outside. Next, summation of, see, it is considering the summation of all the training example which is present in a data set. So D belongs to the D, del of del WI TD minus OD the whole square. Now by performing a differentiation operation, that is TD minus OD the whole square, we are going to obtain by performing differentiation half summation of D belongs to capital D 2 TD minus OD, then partial derivative of del by del WI TD minus OD. So here what happens, this is what the equation after performing differentiation we have got. Now let us look at this particular part. Once again we need to differentiate this part and then we try to obtain the result. While obtaining the result, this is OD. This OD will be comprising, that the output which you have been obtained, it will be comprising of a training example, that is an instance. Along with the instances, it is going to have its own attribute values, and along with this attribute values, it is going to have a weights during the computation. So that OD can be replaced by the vector of X and vector of W. So because the vector of W can be obtained, because if you need to obtain the OD, we require a vector of W and vector of X. X is an instance, or we can call it a training example. So we replace OD by W vector and the X vector. After replacing the W vector and X vector, the next part here is TD is the output unit. The TD is the output unit, nowhere it is containing the W vector or a X. So what we can do is, we can eliminate this value. When you differentiate this W, del of del divided by del WI, differentiate the TD, we are going to get the zero value. So now let us look at, we are not going to consider TD, but we can replace the OD value with the vector of W and vector of X. Now next step is equal to half, it remains as it is, half, cancel it, 2 to cancel, then we are going to get summation of D belongs to capital D, okay, TD minus OD, now del by del WI, where TD minus instead of OD, we are considering vector of W into vector of X, that is instances. If you differentiate this with respect to TD and XD, then we are not going to have the TD. We can't differentiate TD because it does not contain any weight. So we are going to get the result like, result is equal to, that is summation of del of E divided by del of Wi is equal to summation of D belongs to D, TD minus OD. Now after differentiation, this get cancelled, that is become 0. Now with respect to Wi, that is W, if you differentiate, we are going to get minus X, we can write ID, because with respect to the ith instance, or we can call it's a input data, whether it is a x1, x2 instant or x3 instant. So that is xid denotes, see xid denotes the single input component, that is xi, with respect to the training example d. Now what happens, we have got a xi. So xi is a input component or a input unit with respect to the training example d. D is a training example in a data set d. Now what happens, after getting the result, we are naming this as a fourth equation. Now the equation number 4 must be substituted in a equation number 3. In the previous we have seen the equation number 3. The equation number 3 is equal to minus eta del of E by del of Wi. Now substituting this equation number 4 to this equation number 3, we are going to obtain delta Wi is equal to minus eta, that is learning rate. We substituting this equation to here. Now we obtain summation of D belongs to capital D, TD minus OD into, here minus is there, minus of xi d. Now you can change it, minus minus it will be plus. So delta Wi is equal to eta summation of d belongs to d, TD minus OD into xi d. This is how, by using the partial derivatives, we are going to obtain a changed weight value where we are going to have a minimum error, and we try to find out the minimum global point where we can choose the vector so that we are going to obtain a minimum error. Summarize the gradient descent algorithm for a training a linear unit. Now let us look at the gradient descent algorithm for a training a linear unit. When you look at this algorithm say, that is a first step is indicating, we are choosing a training example. A training example is chosen in such a way that it contains a vector of instances and its target value, that is what, x vector comma t, where vector is a, that x is indicating a vector of input values for each of the instances or each of the training example. Okay, the next one is t is representing the target output value. Next, the eta, that is new value, that is we can call it as a eta. Eta is a learning rate, where the learning rate is chosen a minimum value, that is around the 0.05 value, and a positive value is being chosen. The first step in a this algorithm, that is in a gradient descent algorithm. See, the gradient descent algorithm is mainly depends on the updation of the weights. So because of that reason, the first thing is randomly choose the weight value, that is initialize the wi to some small random values. After updating the weight value, the next step here is we should repeat the operation until we are going to obtain the minimum error. That is, what the thing here is, we need to perform, see, whenever there is a classification operation, we have to obtain the output. That output must match with the target output. So that is the main reason. That's why first step is initialize each delta wi to 0. The delta wi is indicating the change of the weight. So first step is first initialize the delta wi is 0. Now for next step, for each x vector comma t in a training example, do the particular operation. We are going to apply the operations for each of the training example, or for each of the instances we are applying the operation. When we apply the operation, we are considering the input vectors and then compute the output and check it out. Check the output, whether the output which we have obtained is equal to the target unit or target value. If the output O is not equal to the target value, then find the difference between the output value and the target value. So next, finding out this, we tries to update the weight so that we obtain the minimum error and tries to match the O, that is output O, with the target value. That's the next step which is performed over here. Delta wi tends to, that is w delta wi plus eta t minus o into xi. That's what the previous partial derivative which we have done, that equation is being provided here. So next step is, after changing the delta wi value, next find out the wi. So wi is equal to wi plus delta wi. So this is how the gradient descent algorithm is going to perform its operation, so that it keep on changing the weight value and tries to find out the minimum error between the output which we have obtained and the target value. So that is about the gradient descent algorithm. The gradient descent algorithm for training a linear units is, first thing is we should pick a random weight value. Weight must be minimum weight, random weight vector. Next, apply to the example, apply to all the units of the training examples. See, in a data set, when it comes to the D is indicating a data set. Data set will be comprising of many instances or many training examples. So apply the weight to all the training examples, then compute the and find out the error, and compute the delta wi, where delta wi is going to be computed as I explained. Next, update the wi, update the weight value, that is what, update the weight wi and adding with the delta wi, then repeat this process until we are going to get a minimum error which come across in a gradient descent algorithm. So gradient descent algorithms is an important general paradigm for learning. It's a most important concept, but its finding, its strategy is to find the minimum error in a large infinite hypothesis space, where we can apply this algorithm, But this hypothesis space contained continuously parameterized hypothesis. And another thing is the error can be differentiated with respect to the hypothesis of parameters. That is what the issue which we are going to come across. The next key partial difficulties in applying the gradient descents are, see, in a gradient descent we keep on, as I said in a previous class also, the gradient descent algorithm, it in a iterative process it tries to find out the global minimum point so that it minimizes the error and choose the weights properly. So that is the first point here. Is this is the key difficulties or a practical difficulties which we are going to come across here. The converging to a local minimum can sometimes be slower process, iterative process, so it's very slower process. And another thing is in a single hypothesis space we can obtain multiple global minimum can also be obtained. So that is what multiple local minimum in a error space, and there is no guarantee of obtaining a single global minimum. So that is the main drawback of this gradient descent algorithm, Now let us move on to the stochastic approximation to gradient descent. Means to, we are going to have the approximating few values to the gradient descent algorithm. Why? Because is when you look at the gradient descent algorithm, it tries to summarize the values of all the training example and provides you the weight. So but that is the main drawback of a gradient descent algorithm. So let us look at the gradient descent algorithm presented in a previous equation, computes the weights after summing up all overall training example. So the idea behind, by to overcome the drawback, the idea behind having the stochastic gradient descent is to approximate this gradient descent search by updating the weights incrementally and calculate the errors for each individual training example. Instead of finding the overall summation of all the training examples and finding the error present in the weights and finding out the overall weight calculation, so instead of performing that, by using a stochastic gradient descent algorithm, we try to find out the weight updation for each and every training example. So that can be done by using this particular equation. That is, according to this, for each and every training example we can update the weight according to, that is, delta wi is equal to nu eta, that is t minus o into xi, where xi is going to represent the ith training example, whereas wi is representing the weight for the ith training example, where o is the output value which we have obtained, t is the target value or a target unit, and it is the positive constant, that is learning rate. Let us look at the gradient descent with a stochastic approximation technique to gradient descent. So when you look at this algorithm is the steps are similar to that of a gradient descent, but the thing here is it is going to address only the one training example instead of summation of all the training example. Now let us look at this algorithm. That is, each training example is a pair of x, vector of x comma t, where x is the vector of input values and the t is the target output value, where the nu or a eta is a learning rate. Now initialize the wi to some small random values according to this algorithm. Next, you repeat the operation until we are going to obtain a proper WI. This means until we are going to obtain a proper result, we need to keep on updating the weights. Now let us look at here. Initial, for each step, x vector of t in a training example, do input the instance x. X is one instance, it contains the vector of input values. Now after that, compute the output. We are going to obtain the output O. The next step is the output O will be compared with the target unit, that is a target value. Now for each unit we find out the target value, compare it. After this, for each linear unit WI, we tries to update the weight value. While updating the weight value, you can look at this equation. This equation WI plus eta T minus O into XI, that is what turns to new weight value WI. That is the last step of stochastic approximation to gradient descent algorithm. So that is the main that's the main alteration which is done for the gradient descent algorithm in the stochastic approximation to gradient descent algorithm. That's all for this class. In the next class, I'll continue the same, that is the stochastic approximation to gradient descent algorithm, few drawbacks and what is the main advantages, and also how the error approximations are being done by using a stochastic approximation to gradient descent in a next class. Thank you.